ni pa sa ni pa ga ri na da da ni do nu da ni
ga re za pa ga re za ni pa ga re za sa ni pa ga re na da da ni do tre da ni tre da ni tre da ni
ni sa pa ni ni sa ga pa ni ni sa sa ri ga pa ni ni sa sa ri ga pa ni ni sa pa ni sa ga ri ga ri ni pa ga ri na da da ni do tre da ni
ga pa ni ni sa pa ni sa ri ga ga pa pa ga ri ga ri sa ri sa ni ri sa ni sa ni pa ni pa ga ga pa ni ni na da da ni do tre da ni
pa ni ni sa ni sa ga ri sa pa pa ni sa ri ga pa ga ga ri ri sa sa ni pa ni sa ga ri sa ni pa ri sa ni pa ga sa ni pa ga ri na dum dum da ni
ga pa ni sa 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 ni sa ga ri sa ri ni ni ga ri ni sa ni sa pa pa ni pa ni ga pa ga ri sa ga ri pa ga ni pa sa ni sa ga ri sa ri sa ni pa ga ri sa sa ni pa ga ri sa sa ni pa ga ri 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 sa
program was nice because it had a collaboration of percussionists and instrumentalists, also including the flute and saxophone, and that went together with the very nice piece. And I think it made me like work more on music because this piece was very hard, and now I, because of all my work, I was able to finish it and have a really good piece to sing and learn with all my fellow folks.
Something I learned here was like how much practice you have to put into synchronizing and going with like making harmonies and everything with other singers and instrumentalists, because it seems easy after the effect, but there is a lot of effort that goes into it. Also, it's really nice because you get to see the music studio and how it is, and you get to sing with other kids, and it's a really nice experience.
Well, the one thing you need to learn was like was a new raga, Rathipathipriya, and I've heard that's very rare, so it's pretty nice to be learning that. So now I can just show it off to everyone, I guess, as long as I live, because it's a pretty, very nice song. I love it.
I got the opportunity to record in a studio, and I always thought it was really interesting to see artists perform in studios. Only like professionals get those opportunities. So it was really nice being a part of this program, so I got that opportunity. I've recorded at home, but it's definitely different to record in the studio and have the headset and record with accompaniment and backup. That's really nice.
Well, I liked that the approach was a little bit more non-traditional, how we integrate Western instruments and also introduce harmonies, which are very much a Western concept. So kind of having the fusion of Western classical and Indian classical was really interesting.
One thing I haven't learned is I've never sung in like a group before, so I've never like had the experience of other people singing along with me to hear how it all sounds together. So I really liked how there were like instrumentalists and vocalists coming together, and it was a very nice experience. What I loved about the studio was the idea of the headphones and like the mic and how it all looked and sounded, because the voice sounded very clear and you could hear so much better.
This program sparked my interest in playing Carnatic saxophone, and I think I'll continue doing that.
Well, at first I was really nervous, but then I realized I could just open up and just enjoy singing.
The piece that I chose for this labs is a Thillana composed by T.V. Gopalakrishnan sir in the ragam Rathipathipriya. Rathipathipriya ragam itself is one of the rarer ragams. It's one of the ragams that hasn't seen the level of evolution that other Rakti ragams like Kalyani or Kamboji or Todi have seen. It's a relatively more scalar ragam, which lends itself well to a chorus setting. It also lends itself well to doing harmonies because it's not gamaka heavy as some of the other ragams, but it has a very nice swara placement or note placement. The patterns that it follows lend themselves very well for harmony, so that's the reason this piece was chosen. This Thillana also is, like I said, it's T.V. Gopalakrishnan sir's composition, so it's a contemporary composition as opposed to other Thillanas or other compositions that we present in Carnatic music tend to be more, when we say traditional, we mean older composition, maybe 200, 300 year old compositions. This one was composed in the 20th century, so it's relatively newer, which also goes to show that our music is still fresh. It's not the 2000 year old art form that we are presenting. It's as fresh as the listener considers it to be, and even compositions are being created as we speak. So this is an example to show that a contemporary composition can also be used in a rigorous Carnatic fashion and presented in a group.